Hey guys, welcome from Bulgaria. As you can see, there is a different place. It took me a while to move to this different place, but I'm happy to be here again with you for a new course, this time in Java. Let me share my screen. And in this course, we are going to talk about JUnit together with Selenium. First, let me first shortly introduce the course module and what we are going to talk in this next few videos. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the LambdaTest channel. There are many awesome videos out there about different technologies. Also, you can check LambdaTest blog. There are dedicated articles about JUnit and Selenium already. And in the next 8 videos, part of this course modules, first, we're going to talk in this particular video about what is JUnit, what are the advantages, why you should care, how to migrate from version 4 to version 5, and we'll discuss the different versions. Then in the second video, we will set up JUnit framework for IntelliJ and install all the dependencies. Also, we'll run tests and execute them through command line and generate reports. Then in the third module from the course, I'm going to discuss various annotations and assertions part of the JUnit library. We will create our first automated test using JUnit and Selenium from scratch. Then I'm going to show you in the next module how to run your tests in parallel using JUnit. Then we're going to create test-driven tests, complex test-driven tests using Selenium together with JUnit. Maybe one of the most exciting parts and modules will be how to run your tests in the cloud using the LambdaTest platform. We're going to talk about what is LambdaTest, the advantages, how to run single tests, or tests in parallel. In the next one, we will review some more advanced capabilities of the cloud execution, such as geolocation testing and others. And in the last module, we're going to discuss a few design patterns, but maybe most prominently the page object model design pattern together with JUnit. Without further ado, let's begin. Again, LambdaTest is a cloud platform for enabling you to run both manual and automated tests on your website or web apps across many browsers and operating systems. We're going to discuss many of the features of this awesome platform. Now, what is JUnit? JUnit is a popular Java-based open source framework that is primarily used for unit testing Java projects. You can test websites, web apps by performing Selenium automation testing with JUnit. And keep in mind that Selenium and JUnit can be used independently of each other. Through testing with JUnit and Selenium combined helps to write test cases in a more structured way. And annotations that we are going to learn during the course in JUnit are used for identifying test methods, a variety of assertions, grouping tests into test suites, and ease offered in maintaining tests are major reasons for JUnit's popularity for cross-browser testing. As I said, JUnit is free and open source. The JUnit 5 that we're going to talk in this module is the next generation of JUnit. And fun fact, JUnit 5 is the result of a project called JUnit Lambda that actually was crowdfunded by a campaign. And JUnit 5 actually isn't a monolith thing. Actually, it contains of three parts: JUnit Platform, JUnit Jupiter, and JUnit Vintage. Here is the architecture of JUnit 5. And let's first discuss the JUnit platform. The JUnit platform, the first part, defines the test engine API for developing a testing framework that runs on the JVM, the Java Virtual Machine. It provides a console launcher to launch the platform from the command line. plus JUnit Vibe base trimmer for running any test engine on the platform in a JUnit 4 based environment. And there is a first class support for JUnit in most popular IDEs such as IntelliJ, IDEA, Eclipse, NetBeans, and Visual Studio Code, and build tools such as Gradle, Maven, and Ant that we are going to use in the next module from the course. The second part, JUnit Jupiter, is the combination of the new programming model and extension model for writing tests and extensions in JUnit 5. The Jupiter subproject provides a test engine for running Jupiter-based tests on the platform. And the third and last part, JUnit Vintage, provides a test engine for running JUnit 3 and JUnit 4-based tests on the platform. Here is a sample test structure. The first three rows at the top are basically the imports for the libraries. As you can see, the first one is static. Of course, you can use them with asterisks, meaning that you will include all of the methods part of this namespace and basically package. And at the bottom, since we included imported the static package, we don't need to write assertions.assert equals, right? And as you can see, this method addition, we're testing the calculator that we defined in initialized above. And we, the important part here is that we marked it with the @test annotation. There is a special module about annotations, but I just wanted to show you a sample structure of JUnit tests. Now let's talk about the different advantages. First, keep in mind that JUnit has become a standard for testing in Java programming language. It supports, as mentioned, almost all IDEs, so that you work in, you can work in any standardized IDE environment, you would find support of JUnit in it. You can also integrate AND with JUnit to allow execution of test suites as part of the build process, capturing their output and generating rich core enhanced reports. Also, there is a huge library of assertions and annotations that we are going to discuss in a separate module. You can run the tests from the command line and run the tests in parallel. Keep in mind, in next modules, we are going to talk in much more details about it. You can run the test by priority. You can you have annotations for conditional execution, depending on the operating system and such. Also, you can organize quite easily the tests into test suites. In JUnit 5, the test-driven tests are completely built-in. In JUnit 5, again, you can easily create extensions for the platform. And the fixtures allow you to have a fixed environment in which you can check if the results results are repeatable. Now let's talk about the differences between version 4 of JUnit and version 5 and how we can migrate. Let's talk about a few differences. First, JUnit 4 requires a Java version of 5 or above, while JUnit 5 requires Java version of 8. JUnit 5 leverages features from Java 8 or later, like Lambda functions, making tests more powerful and easier to maintain. Also, JUnit 5 has added very useful new features for describing, organizing, and executing tests. For instance, tests can better display names and can be organized hierarchically. Also, JUnit 5 supports all popular build tools and IDEs, while for JUnit wasn't such the case. JUnit 5 is organized into multiple libraries, so only the features you need are important into your project. With build systems like Maven and Gradle, you can include only the right libraries quite easy. And yeah, JUnit 4 is basically everything is composed and wrapped together. And yeah, JUnit 5 can use more than one extension at a time, which JUnit 4 could not. Here on the next, here you can see that's basically many annotations have been changed before, now have become before each, after has become after each, before class, before all. All of these changes are to make the tests more readable and easier to write. Again, with there will be a separate module that we're going into much more details about the annotations. And now, lastly, let's talk about how you can migrate from JUnit version 4 to JUnit version 5. As you can see, there are a few changes. The first thing is that you need to update imports to remove JUnit 4 and add JUnit 5. For instance, update the package name for annotation test annotation and both the package and the class names for the assertions from asserts to assertions. And don't worry yet if there are compilation errors, completing the following steps should resolve them. Second, globally replace old annotations and class names with the new ones that I showed you on the previous screen. For example, replace all @before with @before_each and all asserts with assertions, right? The third thing is to update assertions. Any assertions that provide a message need to have a message argument moved to the end and pay special attention when all three arguments are strings. Also update timeouts and expected exceptions. There is, by the way, a special article on the LambdaTest blog about the migration. So just search on the internet for this blog post. Also, we are going to include it into the resources below. You will find the link. Four, update assumptions if you are using them. And five, replace any instances of run with rule and class rule with appropriate extend with annotations. Again, below you will find the article with all of this explained in much more detail. Thank you for watching. Hope to see you in the next video part of this awesome course. If you have any questions, you can ask them below in the comments. Also, don't forget again to check the LambdaTest blog for many awesome articles, or you can ask any questions in the rich community of LambdaTest. And lastly, don't forget to check the LambdaTest.com certifications JUnit to earn your certificate for JUnit together with Selenium. You can add it to your CV or LinkedIn. See you later, and thank you for watching.